Concerts are a thing again. Bieber and Billy and Bad Bunny, oh my. That trio, along with the likes of Alicia Keys, Dua Lipa and The Weeknd are hitting the road and we are psyched. Justin Bieber is going on tour for Justice. That's it, that's the tweet. Deborah Yue, Style Collective Coordinator. Nothing says summer like a night of good country music. After being delayed because of COVID-19, Kenny Chesney's Here and Now tour is finally happening and he has promised fans that we're going to get all of the hits. Plus, with supporting acts Dan Shay, Old Dominion and Carly Pierce joining in on the fun, there's no doubt that it's going to be a big party. Who's in? Mike Volpo, editor. Olivia Rodrigo is steering us into 2022 on a sweet note. The Sour Tour will be a highlight of the year, celebrating her beautiful debut album that manages to be both specific to one 18-year-old's heartbreak and be universally relatable at the same time. There's nothing Livvies want more than to cry and sing along in. Lindsay Weinberg, writer, Las Vegas Residencies, 2. Hello, it's Adele, who will be calling from Sin City Caesar's Palace starting January 21st. Meanwhile, Katy Perry will be waking up in Vegas through March. Looking forward to the comeback of major tours and concerts. I already have tickets to see Katy Perry in Las Vegas for her residency debut and to see Billie Eilish's first tour in 2 years in LA for both of her albums that I am still obsessed with. So many artists are starting their tours back up and I am here for it. Ali Rosenblum, senior reporter. Hollywood is going for the gold. Disclaimer, I've loved watching the Oscars since I was a kid, and I don't care if they're 5 hours long, I am all in. That being said, while nothing's confirmed yet as far as returning to the more traditional format with a host, I am hoping for a juke-fueled 2022 Oscars ceremony to wash last year's unfortunate in unfestive celebration of movies from my memory. I don't see the show being a repeat bummer with a girls' trip producer Will Packer at the helm, so here's hoping we can all agree that an uplifting night, no matter how serious or elegiac or ugly cry-inducing some of the best films might be, is what audiences deserve. It's been done before, and I have faith it can be done again. Natalie Finn, Senior Features Editor. I am here for Kristen Stewart getting nominated and winning an Oscar for Spencer. This is her time. Jess Cohen, Assignment Editor. I am looking forward to seeing Lady Gaga win an Oscar this year. Samantha Bergeson, TV and Shows Writer. Ahem, House of Gucci stands, assemble. And we're all hitting the movies. I can't wait to see Mila Kunis star in the film adaptation of Jessica Knowles' Luckiest Girl Alive. I couldn't put the book down when I read it years ago and I am hoping the movie will be equally engrossing. Samantha Schnur, digital editor. As a fan of Booksmart, Florence Pugh and Harry Styles, I am excited to see Olivia Wilde's Don't Worry Darling in September. Plus, Florence, Harry and Olivia have an amazing team of stylists, so I already know that their premiere looks will be top-notch. Sydney Contreras, writer. Good tidings they'll bring. What the world needs now and more of in 2022 is Christmas movies. Yes, even more. While Hallmark has dominated the holiday market with its annual countdown to Christmas programming for the last decade, other networks like Netflix, Lifetime, HBO Max and Peacock have entered the Christmas chat and, honestly, the onslaught of seasonal programming is one of the few things that has bought me peace and joy this December. I don't even need it to be good, I just need it to be filled with twinkling lights, a bearded flannel-wearing hunk in a picturesque small town that would make Stars Hollow rolls its eyes and I am there with Belson, literally, Tierney Bricker, editor. It's time to return to Hawkins. Literally counting down the days for Stranger Things Season 4. I can't believe we have to wait until the spring to see it, but I appreciate the fact that it's being released the day before my birthday, which means I'll be celebrating with a solid Stranger Things binge. I just need more Hopper in my life ASAP. Though, can it come sooner? Ali Rosenblum, senior reporter. Sponsored links by Taboola. Dog breeds that are so loyal they're considered Velcro dogs. Senior Meg, the housewives are back. Yes, the Real Housewives Ultimate Girls Trip just finished streaming on Peacock, but season 2 is already in the can. In the words of Phaedra Parks, everybody knows that this group of Real Housewives is going to bring the drama when they all stay at Dorinda Medley's house. While it's so exciting to see alums like Jill Zarin and Eva Marcille back on TV, Tamra Judge had quite the tease about her status with Brandi Glanville. It didn't start off good. It was a few days of a lot of FUs, she told E! News. Then, she said, I kind of like you. You have to watch and see. Don't mind if we do. Mike Volpo, editor. The Roys too. After that season finale, I can't wait to see all the insane drama unfold in Succession season 4. Jessica Rubinstein Fixel, visual editor. Manifest is taking off. Thanks to a heartwarming rescue from Netflix, our fave plain drama is returning for another season. Actor Josh Dallas, who plays Ben Stone, revealed in November that Manifest was back in production, and we have so many burning questions for S4. How did Cal get back? Will they finally learn how to survive their death date? And what's going to happen with the Michaela, Jared, Zeke love triangle? Lindsay Weinberg, writer. sponsored links by Taboola, top 40 best guitarists of all time, womentales.com, basically catch us on the couch. I cannot wait for premieres of the Game of Thrones prequel series House of the Dragon, Amazon's Lord of the Rings prequel series and the Obi-Wan Kenobi series plus season 4 of Stranger Things and season 3 of my favorite show, The Orville. Corinne Heller, editor. TB scores, again. The Super Bowl rings don't lie, Tom Brady is the GOAT when it comes to NFL quarterbacks. But can he win in the style game? In January 2022, the athlete will venture into the fashion business with the launch of his namesake apparel brand. With a few Met Gala appearances under his belt and a fashionable wife, I have faith Tom is about to create something great. Plus, when has Tom ever given less than 100% on a task? Save me a sweatshirt when you launch at Nordstrom, Tom. Mike Volpo, editor. It's Britney's wedding, bitch. Can safely bet her dad won't be giving her away, and at this rate, not likely Jamie Lynn will be reprising her role as a bridesmaid either. But what will Britney's wedding feature? Her favorite color pink? Or is it really yellow now? Can Donatella Versace work a crop blouse influence into Brit's wedding? Gone, Paris Hilton as her maid of honor. Brody Brown, supervising talent booker. Sponsored links by Taboola. Sothi said Zachariah Kung PHB Weefield Nanak Nak Folk and Karthung Kabzung. Key. Courtney's too. The event of the year? Probably Kourtney Kardashian's first wedding. Veronica Flores, social media editor. Bring on that BDE. In 2022, I will be sitting at the edge of my seat for more Kim Kardashian and Pete Davidson dates in Staten Island. Veronica Flores, social media editor. Beyoncé's new album, A Girl Can Dream, right? The pop culture moment I am hopefully not jinxing and just really manifesting would be a new work of art from none other than Beyoncé herself. Don't get me wrong, I am extremely grateful for everything she's given us in 2021, i.e. be alive in my closet full of Ivy Park, but I am very ready for new music from the Queen Bee herself to set my year off in the best way possible. Kisha Ford, writer.